happy to be here for the second time. I just want to thank the God of this commission. The last 2 weeks was like hell. My father was sick, and I love my father so much. So I went to the home to visit him when I heard about the sickness. I wanted to bring him down to where I work. But the family was like, no, we can't release him to you. Because they're looking at me as a foreign body to them. So I was not brought up with them. But when I came back to my father's house, I loved my father. So I used the force in me to take my father. When I brought my father to where I was working, the condition had become worse than when I went to see him. I was worshiping at a bigger church. I went there, I pleaded to see the man of God. But they said I have to register before seeing the man of God. And I said, register before seeing? I was down, I was weak. And there was this call from my village that said, if anything happened to that man, you will know the family you came into. So I was inside my room, I was crying. I came back from the church, I look at my father. My father can't stand, he can't sit, he can't eat, the spirit was far. I break down. So I was inside my room, I was lying down. I was crying. No one to say, come, I will save your father. But my phone was on. I was playing this FM, and I heard the voice of Papa preaching and praying. And I wake up. He was calling the number and the address of the church. I quickly copied the number and I called him. Before I would say a word, and I said, come to the church. I said, okay. I came in late. That was last 2 weeks on Sunday. So I was sitting at the back. When Papa was here, he now said, I had the name Nelson. That was my father. And I stood up. I came to the front. He talked and talked and talked. I was thinking it was a medical case. A medical case. I never knew that the fight was beyond me. Papa talked and talked. He anointed me here. And he said, as I'm praying for you, your father is responding.
Amen. Your father is now saying, can we give the Holy Spirit a big hand? In the name of Jesus. I release your dad from that hospital bed where they tied him. Where's your mother?
She's with
him. In the hospital, right?
Yes.
Is your dad involved in any family land matter? Family land matter. You're not aware?
It has been settled.
It has been settled. Yoruba say, Omode Omogu, we left. Madata. God will wipe away your tears.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
I pray for Nelson wherever he is. Father, I stretch my hands in the realm of the spirits. And I declare his healing right now.
Amen.
I declare his healing right now.
Amen.
In the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
My dear, you thought it is settled. Or he thought it is settled. But there are some quarters that they are still cooking some things. Are you know what I'm saying? Who is Bridget? Eh? You are Bridget. Bridget, as you are leaving this place right now, your dad will begin to recover.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
He will be well, he will be okay.
Amen.
They won't take him from you.
Amen.
I see you love your dad so much. Come and talk to me. You love your dad?
Yes.
As the devil. Nobody will. God will prolong his days.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus.
Amen.
You will not weep over his premature death.
Amen.
In the name of Jesus Christ.
Amen.
As you live right now, this oil touching you is touching you right now.
Amen.
As I'm speaking, he's recovering.
Amen.
He's recovering right now.
Amen.
I say, he's, come and join me. Church. I say, he's recovering right now. Come and join me. I say, he's recovering right now. I say, he's recovering right now. I say, Nelson is recovering right now. In the name of Jesus, we arrest the law of death. We introduce the law of life.
My greatest surprise, when I reach the hospital, from here direct, I went back to the hospital. reaching there, I saw my dad is sitting down and eating.
Wow.
I was like, is this my father? I look at him. I started crying. I said, God, you have done it. You have shamed my enemies. I quickly took my phone and I called the elder in the house. I said, you were threatening me that if anything happened to this man, you will know the family I came from. I want to tell you that I have found a father. I have found a place. I said, come down and see my father. You want to show me that you are more than me because I'm a different body. I want to show you that I have a house. So he now cut off the call. I went direct to my father. I bought the anointing water and the water. The anointing oil and the water. I took and I said, Daddy, take this. He collect and he drink. And I anoint him with the oil. He said, where are you coming from? I said, from the church. He said, the church that they deny you from. I said, no, I have found one that they do not deny me from seeing the man of God. I just want to thank God. There is a God here. And I believe it. I have seen it. I have tested it. And I come to testify. I come to say, I thank the God of this permission for saving my father and for putting my enemies to shame.
Amen.
Today, my father is bouncing.
Wow.